Marie Bertholdi, joined by Lucas Esper Berthoud. And you've picked a deck for this tournament that's, to be honest, been around for quite a while, Black-Green Constrictor. How did you end up on this deck?
Yeah, good old snake. It was one of the decks on our playtest gauntlet. When you're playing against Luis Salvato, Carlos Romão, and Thomas Enevoldsen in blue-white control, it can be a little bit disheartening. We thought that out of all the other decks, green-black has the best shot to beat it. And after that, we just started tuning it to be good against the rest of the field.
All right, let's take a look here at some of the cards that make up your deck. Here is your four of the most important card, the card that makes the deck, Winding Constrictor. Still great?
Yeah, it's Cobra Kai. She shows no mercy. She makes all the other cards in your deck better. Early in the game, Glint's Lead Siphoner is a threat. Wish Card is a threat. Later in the game, Virtuous Gear Hulk and Walking Ballista can dominate in Bard State. Just the fact that you play it on turn two, you force your opponent to react. They don't want to let you untap with it. Maybe you don't even have any synergy cards, but they're forced to spend a turn with a removal spell, because if you untap, you can protect with a Blossoming Defense or do something absurd.
All right, your next cards I really want to touch on. This should be the Siphoner, sorry.
Right.
At Llanowar Elves and Merfolk Branchwalker. So this is actually a 2-1 specifically.
Yeah.
So was that a little dangerous going into this tournament?
Yeah, dangerous is the right word for it. Those guys, they do die a lot against red-black. It's the main reason why it's not a good matchup. Those are bad cards game one. If you're lucky and you're on the play, you can protect them with Rish Car. And maybe sometimes they don't have the Chainwalker. But everywhere else, they're just fantastic cards. Llanowar Elves has been broken for 20 years now. Glint's Lead Siphoner is better than Dire Confidant in that deck. So we thought it was worth the risk.
And Llanowar Elves, how much does this change the deck from before when it didn't have access to this card?
Turn 4 Gear Hulk. That's it. It also makes Blossoming Defense a little bit better, because you can go Elves turn 1, then any 2 drops with mana up to protect it. It makes Adventurer's Impulse a little bit better as well. So it's fairly good in this deck.
All right, let's take a look at what we're dealing with here. Rishkar, Pima, Renegade, just a staple. Yep. Virtuous Gear Hulk obviously goes in this deck. Thrashing Brontodon, though, this slot here is sometimes occupied by Jade Light Ranger. So tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so Brontodon has no synergy with the rest of the deck. But we thought it was a card that was well positioned against the field. Against a deck like Blue-White, it's a threat that you can deploy, and even if they have Fumigate or Settle the Wreckage, it can take out their cast downs and seal away on the way down, so you're not over-committing to the board when you play it. And against a deck like Red-Black, it blocks well, it can pressure if you play a turn two on the play of Llanowar Elves, and if they try to take down, you can eat a Scrap Heap Scrounger or Heart of Kieran with it. So it's a good card against the field we expected.
Do you think 4 is the right number there? It's quite a lot.
For this tournament, it was. Moving forward, you have to wait and see how the metagame develops.
And 2 copies of Rishkar, Pima, Renegade. How is this card so integral to the deck?
Oh, it's great. Your best starts are turn 2 Winning Constrictor, turn 3 Rishkar. It allows you to have this proactive game plan that pressures an opponent that mulligan, that have slow starts. And, you know, the games you win that way, they're a good part of your win percentage overall. So just having access to a broken start makes your deck that much better.
All right, moving on here. Ravenous Chupacabra, right, kills something. I love it. Vraska's Contempt and 4 copies of Walking Ballista. Walk me through some of these cards here.
Okay, so do you remember all the X1 guys that died to Goblin Chain Wheeler? This is payback. It comes back, it kills Goblin Chain Wheeler, and it traces Capri's Conjure. It can end their offense. If they don't have Chandra or Phoenix to follow up, you get that, you stabilize, and then you can take over late game. I wish we played more of it. I kind of regret it. It's playing Vraska's Contempt. We thought we needed Vraska's Contempt to deal with Hazoret and Phoenix and a Teferi. But Chupacabra on the main deck would have been better. I recommend just playing 4 of that guy.
Were you scared enough of Planeswalkers to consider more copies of Vraska's Contempt than 2?
Yeah, I was more scared of Phoenix than Planeswalkers,
okay,
to be honest. But you have ways to deal with Phoenix. We shouldn't have played that card in the main deck for sure.
And Walking Ballista, 4 copies, just solid, obviously works with the snake.
Oh, yeah, it does everything. It dominates late game. It can be early removal against Llanowar Elves when you're in a draw. You can get 2 counters and just block and trade with Beaumont Courier. It's the best card in the deck. That would not exist without it. It's a fantastic card.
These next couple of cards are kind of interesting. Adventurous Impulse here, a new addition, and 2 copies of Blossoming Defense. So how good is Adventurous Impulse in the deck, and what job does it do?
Yeah, so your deck's that much better when you have a creature in play by turn 2. Adventurous Impulse makes that a little bit more likely. We can play two main of those because we do have some non-creature slots, so you don't want to risk fizzling it. But yeah, it has been good. We take it out of sideboard when we're bringing in more spells. But it's a good main deck card. It's also a way to use the mana from land or elves.
And Aether Sphere Harvester, how about that?
It's a card that's good when you're on the draw. So you can't always have, you know, be proactive on the play. Sometimes you have to play catch-up. And since we don't have that much removal in the main deck, having something like Aether Sphere Harvester when you're on the draw, it's amazing. Of course, in late game, you can also get completely out of control when you put counters on it and attack for a huge lifelink.
How many of those do you run in the deck?
Just one.
Just one. And yeah. Blossoming Defense, do you ever get some blowouts here with this card?
Yeah, it's always a blowout. It's either horrible or it's a blowout. Again, we thought we needed help against red-black, so we traded some of those numbers around. Some guys are playing zero, some guys are playing two. I ended up in two. I wanted to get lucky and blow out my opponents.
All right, let's take a look at your mana base here. We've got four copies of Aether Hub, four copies of Blooming March, one Ifnir Deadlands, and four Woodland Cemetery. So four of, except for the Ifnir Deadlands. Why this one copy?
Yeah, so again, it's a concession against Rekindling Phoenix. It happened once during playtested where he killed the 0-1 guy. And so, okay, I want it in my deck. I want to deal with Phoenix. It's kind of awkward because you do want more basics, so your Woodland Cemetery gets a little bit better. But we thought we could get away with it.
And your basics is the last sort of cards rounding out your deck here. Anything special here?
Yeah, just I play a little bit more shrimps than other deck lists because I want to make my Super Carbon Vraska's Contempt turn two. Especially after post-board where you're taking out Cleanseless Siphoner against a large number of decks, so you're not seeing as many cards. So I just wanted to make sure I had a good solid mana base.
So how happy are you with the deck choosing it for this tournament?
So I just lost two matches in a row, so I hate this deck. Throw it away. Piece of card. No, it's okay, deck. We got the meta game a little bit wrong. We expected Red Black to be the most popular deck, but not by that much. And I also expected to see more control decks. It happens.
Well, thank you so much, Lucas Esper Berthoud on Black Green Constrictor. More magic after this.